There's, it's such an energetic.
Say good morning, come on in, come on in. There she is. What are you doing? I'm getting pictures. Smile. You're the man in purple. Yeah, you're in that. I know what purple that is.
Yeah.
You all need anything? We're good?
I had my gold bandana and just left it.
Hey, you actually, if you'd done that, you would have matched the facility.
That's right.
It's all good. It's goldenrod and ironweed are the colors of TTU.
Nice.
Yes. Okay. Oh, my gosh. We ready? Say good morning. If I don't film everybody now, it won't get, you know how it's going to roll. So we're trying to get everything in. Hey, let me get a picture. Smile real big. Good, good, good.
How are you this morning?
I slept 3 hours. I feel great.
So you're good for the weekend?
I am great till next week. It feels like homesteading. Good morning. How are you? I said I better film now. You got Teresa. How are you doing?
Good morning.
We're doing good. The rain's held.
Yeah, we hit an area.
Open up them pralines, girl.
Good morning.
Show us them Tennessee chocolates. Oh. Good, so y'all get together and smile. This is great. Right, right, yeah, yeah, yeah. Okay, we'll do this one.
Oh, wow.
Oh, Miss Pauletta. How are you? Wave at us.
I can better wave.
We're getting you now. The place looks good. Good morning.
Good morning.
How do you like the facility?
All good.
It's good, isn't it?
Yeah.
We like it. Okay, we're getting into bees.
Ruth.
Hey, Patera, how are you, girl?
Good.
All
right. We pay $5 to take them.
All right, here we go. Well, good morning. How are you?
Good.
Are you going to have fun today? What's your name?
Colton.
What is it?
Colton.
Nice to meet you, Colton.
Psalm 116. I love the Lord, for he heard my voice. He heard my cries of mercy, because he turned his ear to me. I will call on him as long as I live. The cords of death entangled me, the anguish of the grave did not prevent from me. So if they feel threatened, they're not going to run away.
So, Mr. Jim, how are you feeling about the day and the festivities today? It's early morning, but it's going great.
It is going wonderful, and I'm really happy with all the people that are here to help with the project. And I don't know, I've met a lot of wonderful
beautiful
people already.
Man, you've got a major setup out here. How was the sleeping arrangements in your beautiful tent?
Oh,
no rain, right?
It rained at 3 o'clock this morning.
But not too bad?
Nah, okay. I didn't get wet, so I'm not bad.
We kicked all the rain to Kentucky.
Yeah.
That's what we did. Look at all this. Okay. All right.
You can get different ones just to keep the stuff up there. The reason I have these came out somewhere. What's your name? Oh, hey, hey, oh, hey, oh.
22 Turkey, several Redtail Hawk, several Cooper's Hawk, and Blue Jay. And those represent a more diplomatic, especially the heron and the multiple eagle feathers.
Like 1701 through 1800. But I'm going to get a little, I'm going to expand a little bit, and I'm going to say the 18th century. When I look at it, I look at the 50 years before, and I look at the 50 years after, and then I actually recenter my time period a little bit. I go to, say, 1770s and say that's the middle, and then I refocus and look back at 1750 through, say, 1830. That's the time when the United States is being formed. And that's what I want to study. That's what I think is most important for us to look at. We look at an important person, and we say, who were his parents? Who were her parents? What was her childhood like? What was her schooling like? What was her first job? That's when the person's formed. That's going to tell us about what that person's going to be like in later years. So that's why we concentrate, or I concentrate on this time period. I want to know what's happening at the beginning of the United States. And I study, and I particularly am interested in living history. And living history, that concept, or let's say that phrase, is only, say, 30 or 40 years old. I might open up living history and call it more than what some people do. Living history, well, first, it isn't dead history. It isn't that stuff that you got in high school history class that you thought was dead boring, that you couldn't stand. You want living history. I want history that applies to me. I want living history that has to do with real people, not abstract concepts, years, you know, dates, that kind of stuff, what countries, and even what giant war things are going on. I want to know what's happening with individual soldiers, with individual people, what their skills are like, because that's what applies to me. That's what applies to you. So that's living history. It also has to do with doing history. What we should continue to do and what we should not do. This is living history.
And I'll raise your hand.
Do this thing. That's going back to history and not do.
Okay, how are we doing? I'm doing a check. How are we doing?
We're doing great.
We're doing good?
Doing great.
Everybody still sweating? We get a lunch break right now. So,
oh, okay.
Did you get a hot dog yet?
No, we've been eating snacks.
She's snacky. She's probably eating all this chocolate down here from Tanner's.
Tell us more about these kids you mentioned. So, I don't know where you live, sir, but here in Tennessee, I got my kid in a place open in McMinnville, not too far, Morton's Agricultural Supply.
They were like, we're okay. I'm like, okay, all right. All right, guys, welcome to Chickens with Children, and we're gonna talk about chickens. It's not just for children, because I see a lot of old kids in here, but we're gonna have a lot of fun. Guys, we have, this is like a once-in-a-lifetime opportunity for me and for you. We have Miss Gail Damereaux in the arena. How amazing is this? Thank you for being here. Yes.
They really cared a lot about, so that day by day, hour by hour, they were feeling like they were on track with their heart's passion. We can't always do that. Everybody can't exactly do that, I guess. But that is the way that I have lived most of my life, is doing something that I believe in, even though everybody told me that I couldn't. I just went ahead and did it anyway. And a lot of that has to do with homesteading, traditional life ways, and then I like to blend traditional ancient life ways and nature patterns with the creativity and the freedom that starts a lot of upstairs in your head, just the thinking process to realize you can take the ancient and you can come up with creative new.